All right, I'm here with Lea, is it Banken?
Banken.
Banken, yes. Okay. And Del Nathan, thanks for showing up. And, you know, I usually say, I meet a lot of people doing this stuff, and it's usually not under good situations. So I always say, it's nice to meet you, and then it's not nice to meet you. You know how that goes. But I appreciate you coming on the show to tell your story and what's gone on in the courtroom, which has just been atrocious to me. But where I want to start, I kind of want to start at the end and then kind of go back to the beginning. And of course, it's not the end yet, obviously, but at least the latest things that have happened. So why don't we start with the writ of mandamus aspect. So a judge issued an order. What did he issue that order about? You know,
regarding the blog.
The blog. You have a blog.
I have a blog. CarverCountyCorruption.wordpress.com.
And you can see it right under there on their, the website there. So, okay.
And I was ordered to take it down.
You were ordered by the court to take down a blog. Did the court say why you were ordered to take it down?
No, I don't believe so.
They did not.
No.
And so with the order, did they fine you or just say take it down or?
Yes, I'm being fined. I think it's $50 a day, and there's so much for every day that each post is available to the public, and thousands of dollars, pretty much.
Okay.
And actually back charging, and yeah, I don't totally, I didn't pay too much attention, but yeah, it's...
Now, is this your blog, or somebody else is doing it? What's...
Well, there's quite a few people that are participating in it.
Okay.
Yes.
And you don't, do you have anything to do with it, or...?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I mean, you're giving a lot of information to people.
Yes.
Which, you know, which is your liberty and your
right. Yeah.
So with this order, which is just outrageous because it's a violation of free speech and just because it's a court case.
It's embarrassing to the judge. That's the big point.
That's the big, and this is Judge.
It's criticizing Judge Perkins.
Judge Richard Perkins.
And he doesn't like it at all.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, who likes to be criticized? But, I mean, you're an elected official. Of course, he was first appointed by Arne Carlson, but you're an elected official, so, you know, any legislator, a governor, you know what they would say is just man up. You know, this is part of the deal. You get to write with the power of the pen, and you get to destroy lives, and people can't respond. I mean, it's outrageous. I mean, it's really insanity. And it's really a form of self-centeredness or narcissism that they can't be criticized.
It's a means of preserving their power. They don't want to be criticized. They don't want their job to be in danger. So they want to stifle criticism. And Lea is a source of criticism of Judge Perkins because of what he has done to her.
Well, definitely. And it takes a lot of guts to speak up, and there's a lot at stake, but in this case, not so much anymore, but there still is with your kids. But so with this order, of course, the right thing to do is you filed an appeal.
Yes.
And that was a writ of mandamus?
It was a writ of prohibition,
actually. Writ of prohibition, okay.
Yes.
And that was to go to the appellate court, and the appellate court has to take these, you know, I've done a few of these, but they have to respond. You got to do it. Once you serve it, they have to respond within a couple weeks.
Correct.
How long did it take the higher court to respond?
About 4 weeks. The writ of prohibition was filed on August 16, and the decision came out just yesterday.
Yeah. Okay. And what did the decision say?
The decision is totally lacking in common sense. What the decision says is, well, Ms. Banken, you have a remedy. You can appeal. Of course, Ms. Banken doesn't have any lawyer. She has no money, and she's not a lawyer. So saying to her that you can appeal adds 9 months to the review process. It's impractical because she is not a lawyer. She doesn't know what to do. But more importantly, the assessments amounting to thousands of dollars are now going to be a judgment against her. And so she has to fend off having to respond to garnishment, to executions, to all manner of collection while trying to preserve, you know, what she has, which is nothing. And so as a practical matter, there's no remedy at all for Ms. Banken. She's at the mercy of Judge Perkins, who is violating her constitutional rights, and the appeals court is letting him get away with it.
Well, what can Judge Perkins do between now and whenever? Let's say the appellate court time. Can he bring Lea in and say, I'm going to punish you more, or throw her in contempt of court for not taking the blog down? What can he do?
He could do all of those things.
He can do all of that. Mm-hmm. And so if she appeals, does the long process, once she notices the appeal, puts the appeal in, can that stop the judge from then holding her in contempt?
No, she can ask the judge to what they call stay the assessments, but it's his power to stay or not stay the penalties he has already ordered.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So you're in a precarious situation.
Yes.
Well, if it's any comfort, no, it's not. I've been in the Carver County Jail. It's nice. Some of the people you meet there, you know, it's a little different, but it's a nice facility, you know. But you don't want to be there, absolutely. And I jest with that, but it's not a game, and this judge shouldn't be doing this.
Well, the judge is doing more. Mm-hmm. He has approved denying Lea any contact with her three young children, ages 1, 5, and 7. She has not seen them for over 3 months. They will not allow her to express her love for those kids or allow the kids to express love for their mother. She is not allowed to care for the kids. The kids are being cared for by a complete stranger, a nanny, whose qualifications are unknown, whose history is unknown. And this takes place every day. Lea misses her kids, as any mother would, tremendously. Mm-hmm. And she's worried about them. And she knows that they are not in good physical condition. But she's not being allowed to do anything toward expressing her mother's love for these kids, to protect them from possible sexual and physical abuse. She's not allowed to do that.
Well, you know, it begs the question of, I mean, somebody in the audience is going to be thinking, well, come on, you know, the judge must have found something that you're a real bad mother. There must have been some findings of fact. Mm-hmm. There must have been a hearing. There must be some conclusions of law. Those are two elements, findings of fact, conclusions of law, in order for this order to be written to take the kids away.
You would think there would be something like alcohol abuse, drug abuse.
Physical abuse.
Some physical abuse. But the fact is, Lea has not even been charged with any such abuse. There is no court finding that she has ever committed any abuse or neglect or mistreated any of her children. Lea is what she appears to be, a very loving mother who has an excellent relationship with her children, who has tried to protect them, and Judge Perkins will not allow her to do any of that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, we have a phone call here, and so caller, do you have a comment or question?
Hi, Tim, excellent show.
Thank you.
And I didn't know much about this issue, and you should post some more about these issues, this is fascinating.
Caller, I just want to let you know. Caller, can you hear me?
She thought about taking down that blog and putting up another blog. Oh. Or doing some more public access TV shows so more people can be informed of what's going on. We know nothing about Perkins. Could you give us an overview on who put him in, why he's still there? This seems unbelievable. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, caller. You know, this is your first time on local cable TV. I do know they have it down there in Carver County, local cable, because I just did a shoot for them down there.
Well, I have a question for Lea. Lea, why do you think Judge Perkins is doing these things. You've actually been in front of him a number of times, haven't you?
Yes, I have.
What are your conclusions as to why he's doing what he's doing?
There's money behind it. Point blank. Done over with. It's money.
And is that federal funds?
Mm-hmm. Federal grant money. It's fraud, and you know, I suspect a pretty big chunk of my settlement out of the marriage, which was completely denied as well. And there's a lot more deceit and things behind this than what meets the eye.
In most divorces, normal divorces, things get split up. And your husband decided to leave you, and the assets are divided half and half. Supposedly.
Right, yeah.
I mean, that's the
rules.
That's
what everybody thinks happens,
yes.
Right. Yeah.
But judges have discretion. If there's disability issues or various issues, they can lean one way or the other. Mm-hmm. But in this case, you ended up with nothing.
Mm-hmm. Yep, and there was instigated high-conflict custody litigation by court appointees, including the judge, and everything was depleted. We had a custody evaluator that charged $20,000, and initially
Mindy McNick, familiar name, yep. Does not have a good reputation.
No, not at all. And she, initially was paid for by my husband, ex-husband, and in the end of the divorce decree, of course, I was charged half of that, and I mean, it's...
Half the fees for the custody,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, legal fees. I mean, it just, yeah. The judge actually charged me for my wedding ring and my band, and because I was pregnant actually when my ex-husband left. I was 16 weeks pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I was in the hospital for dehydration. I was very sick. I wasn't with the first two, but my third pregnancy, I was very ill. And he filed for divorce, and literally he was very, controlling during the marriage with money and things like that, and he just cut off completely everything afterwards.
And
couldn't get groceries or...
And so my understanding is also kind of manipulated into selling some of your things.
Well...
Was this before he let you know of the divorce, or...
Yeah, I didn't. I mean, of course, things weren't going that well, and it was actually right when I found out I was pregnant. For some reason, something switched, and things kind of went downhill from there. And he just didn't come home one day, and I was served divorce papers and couldn't afford a lawyer and couldn't.
In the meantime, the assets you had, he was having you liquidate.
Yeah, you mean after he filed for divorce?
Before?
Yeah, I mean, I had a. $11,000 wedding ring, and I couldn't buy groceries. My kids just started school, and, I had school pictures, and, I needed gas money and all kinds of things. I was pregnant and very sick. In fact, in the hospital, I wasn't able to get the anti-nausea medicine mm-hmm. because I had nothing, couldn't even purchase it, so.
And cash, any cash that there was, you didn't have access to any of that at all?
Oh, never.
So your husband retained full control of any cash any assets?
Yes, everything. I wasn't allowed on checking accounts, credit cards. Mm-mm.
And so the judge gave you nothing mm-hmm. in order to help defend
right.
yourself?
He actually put her thousands of dollars in debt. She wound up, as part of the division of assets, she got nothing, absolutely nothing, but she did get thousands of dollars of debt that she owes her ex-husband, who in fact is a millionaire.
Yeah, he's very wealthy.